Okay, you've been up all night writing this great document. You're finally done and you want to share it with the rest of the world. There's a few different ways to do that, and we're going to talk about the options right now. The first way would just be to go to File and select that you want to publish to the web. So when you publish to the web, what it does is it takes kind of a stripped down version of the document, pretty much just the words, and it allows you to post it on the web. So we'll left click on that. And let's leave it as link for now. And that just gives you a link to where this document is going to be. Let's copy that. And I'm going to go in the upper right hand corner. I'm going to open up a new window. But this one is what's called incognito. So this is not logged into my Google account. So what I'm doing is I'm simulating someone else that has nothing to do with me. They're not logged into my account. We'll put the link in here and this is what they'll see. So this is a very bare bones version of your document. It does have the words, obviously. It also has the font type and the sizes, but that's about all. This will load faster. You can have 1,000 people in it at one time. It's still hosted on Google servers. If you look up in the address bar, it's still at docs.google.com, but it's shared with anyone that wants to look at it. So let's go back to Google Docs. You can share that link any way that you want. But some of the easier ways are built in here where you could just kind of a shortcut sending out through your email account, or you could post it on Facebook or Twitter. But if you're at a school or a company and you want to limit just to that entity, you can left click on require viewers to sign in. So I'm going to left click on that and let's go back to that other window that I had open. We'll refresh it. And since this isn't logged into my Google account, it won't let me view the document. All right. So that's the basics of publishing your document as a link. And if you want to embed the document, what this does is it gives you code that needs to be copied and pasted onto another website. So you have to have access to a website to do this. So let's try it out. I'm going to uncheck require viewers to sign in. And I'll just always leave this checked. I'm assuming if you publish it, you want it to show any changes that you made. Let's grab this code. And we'll go over to the back end of my website. This is just a code editor in WordPress. If you don't know what this is, you're probably not going to be able to embed it because you don't have a website. That's right. Skip past this part. Timestamps are down in the description of the video if you want to go to sharing. But if you do have access to a website and you can edit the HTML code, you would paste this in. And let's take a preview of what that looks like. So this frame is going to be here on all my web pages. And this title came in automatically. That has nothing to do with Google Docs. But what Docs did was it came in this iframe here. So when it embeds something, it's putting it into an element called an iframe. Scroll down, you can see the document. But obviously, this isn't the optimal configuration, right? You probably want it wider and you want it taller. So let's go back to the HTML code. And we'll just tell it that the width should be 90% and the height 300 pixels. And there we go. Looks a little bit better, right? Change it to however you want it. It'll give you a scroll bar if it doesn't have enough height to show the entire document. And that's an embedded published Google Doc. So the other option on how to distribute Google Doc when you're done with it, let's close this out, is to share it. And this is when you start giving people access to this actual interface that you're seeing here. So when they log into it, if you shared it, they're going to see the file menu and probably have this toolbar here. Basically, they'll see what you're seeing. So let's left click on share. Okay, so once you go into the share menu, you'll get this interface and there's two different things that you can do here. You can either work with the link or you can specify specific people. So you would type in email addresses in this input box here if you wanted to share it with specific people. Let's just do this guy and I can control whether or not he can edit it. He can leave comments or he can just view. So this is gets less as you go down. If you can just comment it, you can't edit it. If you can only view, you can't even leave comments. You can just look at it. So if I were to do this, let's say I would give him view privileges. You would add a note here, say, hey, Michael, I would like you to look at this document that I just created. Leave that check on notify people and send it to him. The other way to share it, which it doesn't have to do with specific people, so let's take that out, is to get a shareable link. Now left click on that and it will bring up a few more options. Let's click on advanced to see them a little bit better. So right now, anyone at my organization with the link can view. So let's say we want to change that. Here are your options for link sharing. So the most restrictive is at the bottom and it gets less restrictive as you move up. So the first one would be link sharing's off, right? That's the way it is if you had not changed it at all and it's only available to those people who had their email address typed in. Or you can make a private link, but anyone at your company could access it if they have the link. You can make it anyone at your company or school can access it. So these two options will only be here if you're on a school or a G Suite account. And then a less restrictive option is to turn link sharing on so anyone with the link can get into the document. But it's a long random link, so you can't just guess it and find it. You'd have to be given the link, but if you have the link, you can view this document. And then the least restrictive one is on public on the web. So this means anyone could theoretically search for this document and find it. They don't have to know the link. And all of these options are also controlled by this dropdown. So let's say we're doing on anyone with the link. Right now, you're just saying they can view it. But if you want them to have a higher level where they can comment or an even higher level where they can edit, you would change it here. All right, so with these current settings, you're saying anyone with the link can edit the document. So those are the two different ways to share a Google Doc. You either publish it on the web or you share it. And with the sharing, it's more pointed towards collaborating with other people. And publishing it is just making it viewable on the web. It's lightweight. It doesn't actually load Google Docs. And as I went back and watched this video, I was thinking I should probably put in an explanation here. The text in this document was generated using a random paragraph generator I found online. It does look like I was writing poetry. However, I was not. So in this next video, we'll talk about how to create a table of contents, and you can do it with or without links. See you in the video. Thanks.